Thank you so much, Mr. Chatterjee. Next, I would like to request Mr. Santosh Pandey, IPS, Deputy Commissioner of Police, Kolkata Police, Cybercrime, to kindly share his insight on cybercrime in the city. Can we have a huge round of applause for Mr. Pandey?
Thank you. I must thank the organizers to giving me an opportunity to come and interact with you. My talk is not that organized as my previous speakers have given you. I was listening to Mr. Chatterjee. He was giving us very important data, I mean, based on the facts and figures, that cyber security is becoming more and more important. It has moved. It is not confined to chief information security officer, but it is becoming boardroom agenda also. I was also going through such similar report. I mean, there are some firms which publish cyber crime survey yearly. I mean, KPMG and Deloitte, all these. So we have, in one of the survey, we saw that after, cyber security is the second most important crime that is taking place in these firms after criminal misappropriation. So this is the second most thing. And in one of the survey, I also saw that only 3% of the cases are actually reported. So see how important it is to discuss these things among ourselves. What is happening in one firm? Let us learn from each other, not the other way. I mean, once I suffer, then I learn these things. So only 3 cases are reported. And in the survey, it was mentioned that most people were not aware that where to report. It is actually happening in cybercrime. As Mr. Bucknell mentioned, that cybercrime has no boundaries. I can tell you, a case was mentioned regarding scheming. A case, we are still investigating the case. Some persons had fixed some schemers in certain ATMs in the city. So once you insert your ATM, your data is copied there. With the help of that data, they prepared clone cards and they withdrew money in Delhi. And the preliminary investigation suggests the persons were from Europe. So see, it has no boundary. They collected data in Kolkata, they used it in Delhi, but they are actually from Europe. I can give other examples also. Mr. Bucknell also mentioned about the like certain call center things. There are a group of people here who run so-called call centers. They simply called people in other countries. They start with Australia. They work in 3 shifts. They start with Australia, then Europe, then US, I mean America. They simply call that we are calling from some headquarters, Microsoft or some other company. Some they will mention there is some issue with your system. We want to correct it, and you have to pay this much money. So this thing happened there also. So the crime they are committing in maybe Britain or France, and they are sitting here. So it has no boundary. So this only emphasizes the need of more and more interaction and cooperation among different sectors, different agencies, all the stakeholders. We have seen that the pace of development of technology is very fast. 15, 20 years back, all the processes were manual, but now all the data is digitized. We are moving, financing also through digital platforms. So these data and finance, where money is involved, criminals will be attracted where money is involved. We may discuss that we have developed technology. Now we are talking of Internet of Things. There is we can see that now air conditioners are controlled by your mobile phones. So for us, this is one node in the internet or flow of technology. But for a hacker, this is also a way to enter into the system. So I want to test whether I can disturb your air conditioner here or not, because it is controlled by your mobile. This is hypothetical example I am giving. So technology is moving very fast. Banks have completely transformed here. Digital, I mean, all the processes are digitized, but we could see last that a simple skimmer could cause a great loss to all the banks. But when we talk about cyber security, I don't make big claims because we are concerned only when that security is breached. Only then the police comes into picture. But for that matter, we need to learn more and more. We need to interact with you also. Another thing that I would like to mention here is that the cyber security, breach of cyber security is not related only to the criminals. Criminals may commit some crime for some gain, some money. But here we can see big firms are involved, your rivals are involved, even countries are involved. We can see, we come across news that one country is trying to influence the election result of other country. So this is the scenario, how big thing it has developed into such a big thing. So there is more need to discuss these things still, because the process is so fast. Now we have started talking about more fourth industrial revolution and artificial intelligence. We need a lot of data, and our data is with maybe some Amazon, some Google, not here. So they may utilize those data. We come across other new technology, blockchain technology that we need to learn. Cryptocurrency. So these are the things we can share our experience, maybe good practices, maybe some bad experience that has happened to us, so that we can learn from each other. And in that direction, I think this is indeed a great initiative. I would like to thank the organizers for this initiative, and thanks also for inviting me here. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pandey. Now it's officially time to inaugurate the event, and you know, any noble cause, when we start with the blessing of the Almighty. So today also we are going to start with the lighting of the lamp. And I would request all our distinguished dignitaries, Mr. Bruce Bucknell, Mr. Anindo Chatterjee, Mr. Santosh Pandey, and the entire team of Enterprise IT World and InfoSec Foundation team to kindly join us for the lamp lighting ceremony. And I would request all our audience to kindly stand up for this ceremony.
लाल चढ़ायो अच्छा गजमुख को चोंदिल लाल विराजे सुत गौरी हर को हाथ लिए गुड़ लड्डू साई सुरवर को महिमा कहे न जाए लागत हूँ पद को जय देव जय देव जय जय जी गणराज विद्या सुख दाता धन्य तुम्हारो दर्शन मेरा मन जमता जय देव जय देव से कोई शरणागत आवे संत की संपत्ति सब ही भरपूर पावे ऐसे तुम महाराज मोको अति भावे गोसावी नंदन निज दिन गुण गावे.
Thank you to all our dignitaries and audience. You can take your seat. I would request Mr. Mohapatra to kindly hand over the mementos to our distinguished dignitaries. Firstly, to our chief guest, Mr. Bruce Bucknell. Can we have a huge round of applause? Thank you so much, sir, for taking out time and being here. Thank you. Next, to Mr. Anindo Chatterjee. Can we have a huge round of applause? Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Next, Mr. Santosh Pandey. Can we have a huge round of applause? Thank you so much, sir. Thank you to all the dignitaries. Thank you so much for coming here, taking out time from your scheduled, busy schedule. I would request all of you to kindly take your seats. So now it's time to officially start the event. So this is a question for all the audience. Are we all ready? A little more louder, yes would do. No, a little more louder. So yes, this is the energy that we want, and I would request all of you to kindly actively participate in all the discussions that we are going to have, because this is a very important discussion, important issue that we are dealing with out here. And also I would request all of you present in the audience to kindly, if you can, put your mobile phones either on silent mode or vibration mode. Thank you so much. And yes, it's time to start the event. Now I would like to invite on stage Mr. Jyotish Varulkar, Country Sales Manager, Securite, to give a talk on cyber attacks, major concerns of CIOs and CISOs. So can we have a huge round of applause for Mr. Varulkar?
Good morning, everybody. Till the time this laptop getting set up, I'll start. And thank you very much, Enterprise World, Sanjay and team, for giving this opportunity. So the last week we were there in the Bangalore. We had a similar event last week, and I was discussing with Sanjay that in Kolkata we have seen the more excitement in the customer. And in the last 2 days I was meeting the customer, most of the customer is saying that, you know, we are coming, and that's how the, you know, house packed. So thank you very much all. So I represent a company called Quickhill Technologies. Security is our brand for enterprise. So I lead the business for that. And next 10-15 minutes, I'm going to discuss very interesting things, not more onto technology jargon, or neither on the product side. Probably we can take it offline. But since we have been in this industry from last 30 years, we get opportunity to interact the customer like you. So we have almost 30,000 plus active customer in enterprise, in B2B space. So basis on that, we also try to understand the pain point of the customer in terms of the cybersecurity threat, and that's what exactly I'm going to discuss now. So as you all know, and I was surprised that that earlier the dignitaries it has been very encouraging, rather, that they, being a government authority, and the Webel chairman has also got the very interesting facts. They have been up to date and what is going on, and shows the interest that everyone has got into the cybersecurity. Yes, cybersecurity landscape, threat landscape is changing every day, right? And we call in our industry that antivirus software is the only software which get obsolete in an hour, not even in a day, right? So just to, if you can imagine, how many viruses that do you think that we get the sample this industry, in India specific I'm talking about? So any guess is free. So what, 100,000, how many viruses do you think that every day that is getting, we are getting, or any security company is getting? Sorry? Yeah. So infinite, 1,000, yes. So 1,000 were the numbers 20 years back, right? So if you see, every day, now we are getting 4 lakh plus viruses every day, where a team of 100 plus 120 engineers is working 24/7, which work on this virus sample. We come up with the signature and the update, and in a day, thrice minimum, we send the update to the user. So this is how it is becoming more sophisticated. And the cyber criminal, the bad boys, is one step ahead, always try to be one step ahead, right? Whatever we think, they think next step. So we have to be updated. So I'm going to talk about the major threat. What we are saying is, supporting by the fact, if you see the average cost of cyber attack is almost a five million, was over a 5 million. And if you're talking about the one employee, average is 300 USD plus for the per employee. And in 2017, this is the data of India specific. Being an Indian company, always try to talk about more onto the India specific. So 25 to 30% of the organization experienced the one of the breach in the last year, that is 2017. And when we talk to the customer, 7 out of 10 customers is saying that yes, there is a security risk which is increased. They are actually experiencing it. They have been affected by that, or they feel that, you know, they have to be ready with this. And one thing, you know, SMB or the smaller customer is always think, why I'll be a target for this, because I am not a big company. But that's a myth. And I'm going to cover you that very exciting, you know, example and the use cases here. See, nowadays there is we call it as a ITization of consumer and consumerization of the IT. So put it in a simple way, if you see that consumer, let's take the example of the BYOD, right? All the devices of the personal devices is getting used for the corporate use. Employees started using the mail of the enterprise. So, and this is something, you know, we have to, to run the business, to have the productivity, we cannot stop it. Meaning the simple, simple thing to do, don't take your mobile to the, or the tablet to the organization or the work environment. Is it going to be a solve the problem? No, it will be hamper the productivity. So the last week I was, the last month we had one customer, one of the leading hospital in Jaipur. So what an interesting case study. They have given the smartphone to the doctors and the nurses there, 400 plus staff they have. They have got almost 2,000 plus bed hospital, multi-specialty hospital. When I was discussing with them, and they said that, I want to have the compliance, security, productivity, and the control over the devices which I have given to my employee. Otherwise, you know, typically in the night shift, employees, we have seen that they are busy doing the WhatsApp and surfing on the YouTube rather than taking care of their patient. So we said, why are you allowing that? They are saying that, you know, there are a lot of equipment in operation theater, even into the ICU, which is now we have connected with the devices. And we get the live dashboard, which they have been using through these devices. So they cannot stop it. So then they have some control through the software. So this is how it is, you know. Data loss is something, data loss is a major concern from all this customer, and I'm sure you agree with that. Because if the data is getting leaked, meaning it could be a brand reputation, your brand reputation will be stake, right? It caused the financial reputation, and all these other issues will come when we have this data loss. And we have the legal and financial issues is the major things which we observe. So nowadays, if you see, to cover on more onto the current trend, which are these major cyber security threat? So the cryptojacking, how many of you heard about the cryptojacking in recent past? Yeah, quite a few. So cryptojacking, we have been well aware about the ransomware outbreak which we had in the last May, right? This is actually, if you see the different structure we have seen observed in the cryptojacking. Imagine that your computer is being used by somebody else, you know, for their financial benefit without your permission. This is what the cryptojacking, right? If your computer, meaning there will be a malware which will be come through the website portal or through the any attachment. Once that malware is get injected into the PC, your PC will start. There is something called the cryptocurrency mining. So how it happens, sir also talked about the Bitcoin, that is the one of the cryptocurrency. So how to get the cryptocurrency transaction, one way is to get through the mining of the cryptocurrency. There has been the blockchain technology which they use. So and for that, they get the hackers get the money, benefit for that. So what they do basically, that they will, you know, try to inject some malware in the laptop, and you will not even aware that your laptop is being used by the hacker for using this mining, they are running the script. So you may be thinking that, okay, even if they are, you know, some process is going on my laptop, as long as it's not causing me any challenge, so then what is the bad about the cryptojacking? So crypto, this mining of the blockchain, is very resource hungry. So imagine that any transaction of your credit card, okay, consumes the 0.02 kilowatt of energy, electricity. And the similar way, if any transaction of the mining, crypto mining is happen, it consumes for one transaction 200 kilowatt of the electricity. So if you look at the cost, you know, in Indian perspective as well, so normal, to put it in a simple way, your household bulb, whatever the electricity it will consume for 3 months, it will be consumed in a one transaction. So the so much of the loss on the electricity, it is the resource hungry, it utilizes your CPU. So you can even feel that your machine is getting hang, crash, right? And third is actually somebody is, you know, unknown malware or the bad malicious code has been insert in your PC, so it's always the risk. So this cryptojacking is being the threats which we have seen. If you see that this is not the global, which very much is started in India as well. Aditya Birla Group, which it has been attacked, almost 2,000 computer hacked at the cryptojacking. Then these are the news on the talking about their mining, how it happens. So as per the study and the data we publish in our threat report, 33,000 plus website is running the crypto mining script, and you will never know that the website which or the portal which you are visiting, whether it has got this malicious code inbuilt or not. And there are almost the 70% of this profit goes to the website owner, and this is the money earning. Actually, they are getting the profit, right? It gets the hacker, maybe website also involves some of the website, and the hacker gets the per transaction they get the money on the crypting, right? And this is the 1 billion of users are there for the which is visiting the 33,000 website. So this is going to be a more disruption in the coming days. And 4,800 crypto jackers is already been identified. And these are the known crypto jackers, and I'm sure there are many more which is not been quoted and so far identified. So as an organization, as a CISO of the organizations, what would be the measure for this? So there are three approaches to it. One, people, and which is always matters a lot, right? Your employee, then processes, and then it comes to the technology. So one by one, if you see, and this is what we on the ransomware we discussed last year. This is one of the global outbreak on the cybersecurity, cybercrime, which has happened on 12th of May, WannaCry. It has impacted globally, and it was, India was the third largest country which has been impacted by the ransomware. And it came through the malicious exploit of the Windows. And the first it has got, NHS was the first victim there, and it got spread across country, yes sir. if you see the Quick Hill as an organization, we being an Indian threat security company, we detected that on 5th of May, much before it has been officially launched. 12th of May it has been the first outbreak was happened, and we have sent the advisory to the customer. We block almost 12 lakh plus exploits of this ransomware, and also came up with the multi-strong approach on the ransomware. That is, the ART, anti-ransomware tool, behavior detections, because this was the something different approach the ransomware had last time. Then we had a PETA, the next generation ransomware, which has been, again, came last year, and is still going on. So coming to the, now since we all are know about the GDPR, EU has adopted this, on 25th of May is officially been So just to give the brief on that, it's more on to the how to use the any personal information, meaning the sensitive data in the sense government ID or in our case is Aadhaar card, right? Or online, offline activities or biometric. And there is a huge penalty, also almost 4% of the turnover if it not been comply, and it has already been, we have seen the cases which started happen, right? So basis on this, we also as an Indian version of this GDPR has been tabled by Sri Krishna panel. So what is that, you know, a bullet point I will just highlight there. There is a right to privacy. The data which is there available, it has to be a right to have the privacy. Right to withdraw, once we given some data to the user, meaning the for anything that will useful with our consent, we should have always the right to withdraw that data for how much period somebody can use that data. And that one copy of that personal data should be stored in India, right? This is the recommendation. And critical personal data shall be supposed, meaning the data center should be in India. And again, there is a penalty clause which is there. So prima facie, the right to privacy, right to withdrawal, and the one copy of the data should be there in India. That is what the table we are expecting in couple of months that law should be sanctioned and been implemented. So talking more on to the, just to give the background, on the Quikil is being the Indian company from last 30 years. So what is different about the Quikil as an organization, right? So if you see, we have been there in the market from 30 years, and we proudly claim that we are the only company which has got the 8.4 million of endpoint in India. So we have got the India-specific threat intelligence. So 30,000 plus enterprise customer, which includes the government, which includes the enterprise education. So what happens, you know, we have this critical infrastructure organizations, we have the sector-wise data available. So last week we have sent out one communication that we observed that one particular threat string, which was found in our one of the customer in the media industry, and it was very specific to media industry. And we found it in Mumbai, and then second day at Chennai. So then immediately we identify that, okay, this is something in the threat for the media and advertisement industry. Basis on that, we released the signature and the update for that. And we also sent out the PR and so to ensure that the customer in this particular industry will be well aware about the potential threat they could come across. And the same thing happens, you know, HRML is the one organization we came across that there is a threat. So we have informed the other government department. So this is, you know, indigenous threat intelligence is something which we always see that, which is the differentiator. We have got enterprise product line, which is by the name of Securite. We have the security lab in India. We store all data in India. We have the servers, data centers hosted in Indian, that's Pune. Got a global presence. And the one ESP I would like to highlight, you know, apart from the product line, we also have the good support, meaning across 30 locations, we have the physical support available. So, you know, just to give the glimpse, what are the product portfolio we have? So, we have right from the endpoint, you know, to protect your laptop, desktop, we have the endpoint security product line. Then we have on the gateway, we have UTM, that appliances. Then secure web gateway as in proxy server. We have the antivirus for protecting your server. Then we have the mobile device management, the use case which you are talking about, the smartphone, to protect your smartphone and the tablet, the mobility devices. We have the complete range of product line there. And apart from that, see, what is that? You should also updated about the what really is going on your network. So we came up with the Securite services where we do the security audit. We are security SOC, security operational center, which is 24/7 running out of India. And we also do the the ISO 27000, this is more onto the consulting part, the services part. So we are across 30,000 customers, as I mentioned, you know, there are Imami Cement and all, is the customer is from East particularly. So just to summarize here, you know, because I'm because of the limitation of time, just to summarize here, there are three things is very important. I just leave this thought to you, all the CISOs here. The one is that whatever, you know, you do whatever required, meaning there are many applications available, app available. So if you are really required the app, you required anything, you know, online to download, only do that much. If your friend is saying, no, this is game is good, this app is good. So because majority is coming, the app is, you know, you never know which app is, you have to trust and not, even if you download from the Google app and all. Second, we are you know, riding on to this digital expressway. You have to secure the belt. You have to fasten your belt. Then you have to have the basic security in place. Right, and the security has to be updated. When I say the end, in the last week in the conference we met our customer GMIT, he's saying that my antivirus is expired but it's still working, right? So which is something, it will be there on our PC, but what is the use if it's not been updated? As I said, you know, there are 2-3 times all the organized companies are sending the update. So it has to be updated. All the applications you have, right from Microsoft to Adobe and other all the applications, has to be patched, right? They also see the ransomware outbreak has happened because that machine was not patched, Microsoft Windows, which they released the patch. So patching is also important. And third thing, and very important on the processes per se, is that you have to be a paranoid. Right? If you are getting some mail phishing attack, typically if you see, try to, you know, check once, confirm with if it is a genuine sender or not, if you see anything. And if you get the alert, don't, we have the habit to, you know, allow. Right? Even if you give the something pop up, we said allow and we'll move on. So try to be a little bit paranoid and try to understand it. It could be a potential threat. So thank you very much, and I appreciate, thank you for the patient listener. Thank you, sir. Yeah. Yes.
Yes. Thank you. All the threats, like crypto jacking or ransomware or whatever, the recent threats are coming to our PC or our data. Right. So Quick Heal can protect us.
Yes, you have been completely protected.
Okay, so yes. If we do the regular updates.
So only thing you have to see that, you have to ensure that all the, you are getting the update on regular, meaning it has to be, the product should be updated on that. And anyway, whenever, see, when the ransomware outbreak came, we actually, you know, incorporated certain things, you know, we have certain, one thing just to mention, backup and restore. Okay, all your product what you are using has a backup and restore. So what we do on your PC, there is an encrypted vault which we have. So all your important data will be, you know, saved onto that, stored onto that vault which we say backup and restore. And it, since it's in an encrypted format, even if any virus, ransomware outbreak will happen, we can get you recovered. It can, encrypted file cannot be again encrypted. Okay. So you have to be rest assured.
So
now,
the next yes, help is that since we are aware of that the lots of data is hacked through our smartphone.
Right.
So what's the role of Quick Heal?
Yeah.
Will be there in smartphone.
Yeah. So
for whatever you are thinking of dealing with smartphone attack or whatever.
Absolutely. So smartphone, the way we have the antivirus and for the laptop and desktop, if you see here, the we have the enterprise mobility platform. We support the iOS, Windows, and the Android, you know, which caters the productivity, your complete control and the compliance and the security of the smartphone and your tablets. So we have the solution called Enterprise Mobility Management for that.
Enterprise Mobility Management.
Yeah, ma'am.
Thank
yes,
you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much.
Good morning to one and all present here. I'm Shankit. So yes, I have two questions. Yes. First one is, WannaCry came into the attack on 12th May, right?
Yeah.
So how did you manage to get the knowledge of that one in 5th May?
So actually, if you see that the first advisory had actually, no, the hacker actually that published the first outbreak is supposed to be that's kind of, you know, they say that if I get this money, I will not do this attack, right? So the first had come leaked in Jan only from them. But what happens, you know, typically we ignore that, right? But being into the threat research and the security lab, we always see that whatever the malware coming in, what is the behavior of that? We use the machine learning, artificial intelligence on that. So we had, even before May, we had in April only, we got to know and we started working on that. So we declare on 5th of May, when we have been officially confirmed and got a fix for that.
And second question is, like cryptojacking, right? So the security for that is blockchain. When there is a blockchain implementation is there?
Yeah.
With blockchain implementation, like the cryptocurrencies, they are more secure.
Yeah.
So if every industry or all the security companies, if they implement blockchain, then the cryptojacking will be totally secure. So why is that it's not getting legalized? Like blockchain is still not legalized.
Actually, there is actually, I know, if you see the blockchain is something, you know, is the next wave what we are expecting, right? Not just the financial.